Hold on, this computer. Okay, team. Okay, we've got Melody Hoppius on here, and she's going to share with us a little bit. She's going to give us some advice on, you know, how to work the business. First of all, I want to say congratulations to Melody because she just turned Diamond Ambassador. And you guys probably know we've had her on here twice, and I believe, I don't remember what the first rank was. I think the first rank was at Emerald. The second time we had you on here was Sapphire, maybe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so anyway, but she went Emerald, I believe, what, in 5 months? And then
6 months.
Oh, six yep. months. And then mm-hmm. shortly after that, what, 10 months or whatever, I think it was Sapphire.
Sapphire, yeah.
Now she's a beautiful diamond, and she's re-entry diamond. So we're so excited for her and glad to have her on here. But anyway, so is what I'm going to do, Melody, is I'm just going to kind of turn it over to you real quick. Just kind of give our team some advice on, you know, what you're doing and everything. So there was something I was going to talk to you about real quick before we got on here, but it was kind of about stealing the deal, but we'll talk about that another time.
Okay.
So, yeah. So let's yeah. just kind of you give us some advice on, you know, what you're doing to build your business and stuff right now.
Okay. Hello, everyone. So I'm going to specifically talk to you about the business. And coming up, not this coming Monday, the following Monday, I'm going to be on Motivation Monday with Genevieve to talk about business. So I'm going to go ahead. This will be your sneak peek, basically.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Okay. So this is how I coach my team. And remember, keep in mind, you know, I'm coming up on my 2 year anniversary of sharing. My very first time I shared was July the 20th, and of 2018. So I'm coming up on that 2 year mark, and things have changed. The way I present the business, the way I speak more confidently, and that will come as you grow. So just keep that in mind, that keep going, keep sharing, keep learning, keep working on self-development. All of those things are going to play a part in the growth of your business and being intentional. Always remember, this is about people, not points. And when you're intentional about your business, then things will change. Okay. All right. So this is how I coach my team. Number one, this is a network marketing business. That means you have to expand your network. So you need to add friends on Facebook. And I tell them, you need to get to 5,000 friends as fast as you can. Okay. Now you can block the weirdos, you know, learn how to unfriend, unfollow, and block. It's okay. But keeping your Facebook profile public, because here's the other part of that, is you need to allow people to window shop your profile. All right. So you might have people watching you that you don't even realize,
right,
but they need to be able to see who you are besides Plexus. What else do you post about that's going to allow them to connect with you, that's going to allow them to build a relationship with you and to see if this is the right fit for them, right? So I have a lot of people that reach out to me that I actually sign up that are not my Facebook friends. And chances are it could be someone that said to them, hey, go follow, you know, Melody's doing this Plexus thing. Maybe she can help you. And, you know, again, these are people that have never commented or liked anything, but they have had the opportunity to watch. So if your Facebook profile is not public, they can't watch you. Now, if you have sensitive subjects, especially like children and things like that, you can customize that post and make it private.
Right.
But otherwise, you are a business. If you had a brick and mortar, you would go in every day and turn your open sign on. I'm sure of it. You would turn your open sign on because chances are you have a mortgage or a lease or rent to pay. And with Plexus, you don't have to worry about any of that. Guys, it's so easy to promote your business. It's free, essentially, to get on Facebook every day, post consistently, reach out to people, and, you know, just ask. Can you do this with me? I mean, be simple. Don't send long, drawn out you know, messages to people. If you're posting consistently, you're building your network, then you can send that message to say, hey, I'm not sure if you've seen my post about Plexus. I mean, keep it simple, you know, with your messaging too, but you've got to use your social media. You know, my network is still on Facebook. I know Instagram, you know, I do a little bit on Instagram. I do use stories, but I feel like my market is still on Facebook. And people ask me about business pages all the time too. I do not recommend a business page unless you have maxed out on your Facebook friends and have followers, because it is really hard to get a business page to be seen. You have to work that algorithm really hard, or you have to pay for advertisement on a business page. So keep that in mind. So some people will say, well, I don't want my personal news feed full of Plexus. Well, then you're not passionate about this right. business. You know, I'm on Facebook for my business. Yeah. And people know that up front. So I'm not afraid. You cannot be afraid of who you might offend or who you might annoy, because right. you have a business. This is your business. You are a business owner. This is network marketing. How else are you going to network? So post consistently, add friends, join groups, promote your brand. Besides Plexus, what else makes you you? You know, 3 to 5 other things that's going to draw people to you. So most recently, for instance, I've always been into fitness because I was a former owner of a bootcamp fitness business, but things have changed. But something I've done recently is I post about my daily walk. And what we do is I take a picture of our feet. So people have right. started to notice and look for that daily post. It's motivating to them. It's encouraging. And we've created a new brand through this post about walking. So find your brand, use it as well as your Plexus.
Right.
To build interest and to draw people to you. You need to show the energy. You need to do lives. You need to let people hear your voice, see your face. When you're posting, you're making it about you. You're writing out a post that's allowing someone to connect to you. You're not copying and pasting everything. You need to really take time and write up your own post. Get really good at selfies, really good right. at being comfortable in front of the camera, because people need to see your confidence, people need to see your passion, and you need to work on building your voice, okay? Stand behind your products, be a product of the product, stand behind your company, because Plexus is amazing. I mean, that's not even in question.
Yeah.
And then stand behind your belief. Stand behind your belief. And when people see that you're not backing down, you're not stopping, you're sharing some of those messages that people are, you know, sending you about what Plexus has done for them. And thank you for sharing Plexus. It's changed my life. Like, it takes one. All you need is one person to tell you that, to fuel you, to keep going. You're going to have naysayers. You're going to have haters. You're going to have skeptics. That's never going to change. But you need to hold on to your why. And do you know there's 7 levels of why? Look up what that means, okay? Why did you start Plexus, number one? Why? Why did you decide to share about Plexus? Because I'm talking to the business builders. Why did you decide to share about Plexus? And depending on how long you've been around, why do you continue to share about Plexus, right? And keep going, keep asking why? But you need to come back to why you started, why you shared, and I'm sure you've changed one life, one. And if that's what you need to hold on to, and, you know, until you find the right people will come along at the right time and your business will grow. So, but you've got to put the work in. This isn't magic. You can't post and pray and hope that they just magically appear.
Right.
This isn't Lucky Charms. Okay. You have to put the work in. You have to be intentional. You have to be learning and growing, watching diamond documentaries,
yes.
Watching, you know, there's plenty of YouTubes out there from other diamond teams. They share their team calls. They share, you know, use that information to build. Besides that, you know, if you have a team or as you're growing a team, reward and recognize. And I know Don and Greg do this. I see when they post about going to the post office and right. sending out those prizes. You have to invest in your business, right. okay?
Yep.
You have to spend money to make money. Yep. And people love to be rewarded and recognized. And I know for a fact, corporate loves to do that too. So this month, oh my gosh. I mean, corporate is just handing people money left and right. And I mean, go just do the work, share. We have what people need. We've always said that, but right now that is true more than ever. People are more health conscious. And guess what? Kids are going to be going back to school. Yep. And that kid line, our new launch, could not have happened at a better time.
Right.
I am telling you, that was perfect.
Yep.
So we have what everybody needs. What we have is not a want. It's not a mascara. It's not another bag. And I love those things. I support those other businesses. But I don't need another Pampered Chef stone in my, you know, I love those businesses, but
right.
those are, for me, those are not a need, but we need our health products. We need to focus on our immune system and we need to focus on our happiness, you know, health, happiness, community. And I know you guys have a great community too. You have wonderful leaders and you know, that's a big deal too. People are looking for support and encouragement and just positivity. And the Plexus community, the Plexus family definitely, definitely provides that. So,
true.
It's amazing when that light bulb comes on, I'm telling you, when you just get that fire and, you know, nothing's going to stop you from helping people. And that's what we're doing. We're helping people. So that's my biggest tips, guys, is be bold. You know, don't let somebody, you know, you don't get those people out of your ear. You're in complete control of what you see and, you know, hear on social media. So you go in there and you control that yourself. Don't be afraid to remove people or remove comments. If somebody puts a negative comment on your post, just remove it. You don't have to respond. No response is a response.
Right.
You don't need to validate, justify, you know, just remove it and move on and block that person.
Right.
If this, you know, don't be afraid to do that.
Yep.
You want to find the right people to join you on this journey. All right. So, and if you have a team, don't get stuck. Don't get stuck in the people who are not ordering or the people that are not responding. You touch base with them. You let them know I'm here to help you and you move on and you find other people because, you know, Plexus signed 10,000 people the last day of June,
yeah.
10,000. There are more people out there. There's always... We're never going to saturate Plexus because there's still people that don't even know about Plexus and
right.
it's our job to find them. So, you know, just go yeah. do the work, find the people and your business will grow when the time is right. So,
right.
you know, don't give up. Don't give up because when you give up, then guess what? Somebody wins.
That's right.
And you've got people yeah. out there waiting for you to quit so that they can tell you, I told you, don't let them.
Yeah.
Love your products, love your company, love your team, and believe in yourself.
Exactly. So, so true. Great, great, great advice. Okay. I have a quick question for you too. Okay. For instance, okay. Say you've got somebody that joined your team. They go silver real quick. They get those extra bonuses. After they get all those bonuses and everything, then they just stop sharing.
Yeah.
What kind of advice do you have for somebody like that to get them motivated again and get them going? I mean, it does happen.
Again, I would be bold. In fact, I just talked to one of my Ruby ambassadors before this call, and she was very bold with a girl that just did that. And, you know, just told her, like, this is not how this works. Like, you need to share. Just be bold. It's sometimes people do things for the wrong reasons, guys.
Right. Yeah.
And sometimes those people need to be called out. So there's a difference between, did they go silver and get the bonuses with no intention of growing, or did they go silver and get discouraged? So you got to decide, is this what, you know, type of person is this, and how you approach that. So if this is someone who was discouraged because maybe someone said something negative to them, encourage, you know, don't stop. And usually that's enough. You probably will find out that someone has said something to them, or someone, you know.
Yeah.
So encourage, but you have to determine what type of person we have here. Is this someone who, you know, did not have the right intentions up front, or someone that was discouraged along the way? So, but here's the thing too, you keep doing what you're doing, and some of those people, they might start out fast and then take a step back, and then, you know, who knows, 6 months, 9 months down the road, they see that you're having fun. You still haven't stopped.
Yep.
And they decide, okay, I need that. I want to get back. I need to get back on this.
Yes. And that has happened. Yes. That has happened. We've seen that
happen.
Absolutely. Yes. So, So don't ever give up. Just, you know, run away. Yeah.
Keep showing how much fun you're having.
Exactly.
And people want to be a part of that. You know, it's FOMO. FOMO is real. FOMO is real.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. So let's see. Do you encourage like your runners and stuff like that, the people that are really working in the business, do you encourage them to start their own team page? How do you do that? How do you work that angle?
I normally don't, unless they hit Ruby. Again, had this discussion with a senior gold this morning, and I told her if she wanted to do a team group.
I
would use it as like just for incentives or challenges, just, you know, specific to her team, because if they're plugged into our group and some of our uplines, you know, a lot of the things we share are the same, so you don't want to overwhelm them.
Okay.
You know, but if you're growing and you want to start a group initially, then just do it specific to your team for encouragement, for recognition, and for maybe some little challenges or something. But I wouldn't go copy and pasting, you know, the corporate specials or that kind of stuff when they can access that, you know, somewhere else, basically. You can direct them, like, go here, go there, but, you know, you don't want to overwhelm. That's
okay. Gotcha.
People get overwhelmed really easy, I think.
Okay. Another quick question here is, because Greg and I have noticed this, that like sometimes when you go to like your favorite store or whatever, you will like thank them and like tag the store, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So, and then you'll say something nice and everything. So, are you getting like Facebook friends from this, or are you making like Facebook friends with like people at the store?
Well, it's just that you're showing, everybody's
everybody is in network marketing.
Right.
You know, so when you tag a store, you know, you're giving them free advertisement. But the other thing is, depending on how their page and stuff is set up, when people go to that page, then they might see your tag.
Oh,
and then, you know, so it's always good. It's always good to tag places.
Right.
Like that, because when you tag them, then whether it could be the business owner, it could be, you know, who knows, but
true,
it might direct people to go look at your page. You never know.
Right. But okay. That makes sense.
I tag as many things as I can to draw people to my page.
Okay.
And to my post.
Yeah. See, because like on our phones, we actually turned the location thing off. So I guess we need to turn that back on, right?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I guess you have to have that on to do that then,
yeah.
Huh?
Oh, I'm not for sure. Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, okay. Let's see. I got a couple more questions here. Okay. So now, your husband just reached Emerald, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And your daughter, is she what? Senior Ruby?
Ruby.
Mm-hmm. Senior Ruby. Okay. Now, are they directly under you or?
Yes.
They're both directly under you. Okay.
Yeah. So Scott is under me and then she's under Scott.
Okay. Gotcha. Okay. So now, another one quick question is, when you reach Emerald, you know, you get to go to Hawaii, Plexus Lexus. We noticed that your husband, is there like a truck program for guys? Is that what that is? Or?
So you can choose the Lexus or you can choose the lifestyle bonus. So, you know, not everybody wants a Lexus.
Right.
Like a guy. So the lifestyle bonus, the reimbursement for that is less than the Lexus.
Okay.
But it's still an option. So. Oh,
okay. Gotcha. So that's what that, yeah, we just wanted to know about that because we saw that your husband got the truck or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And then you went over the part where you do, you give back to your team, you know, like, you know, prizes and stuff like that. So I guess you'd like have a budget that, you know, cause that's way with us. We try to, you know, we have a budget, so you know, we give back to our team, like you said, that because yes. People love prizes and stuff. They love, you know.
Well, and let's be honest, you need tax deductions.
Right. True. True. That's one thing that we tell people too, when, you know, save your receipts for this, save it for that, because you do definitely need that when you start growing a business. Because we.
That's right.
Yeah, we have we both have our own little thing in there where we keep all of our receipts. So.
Yes.
And everything. One more thing, real quick. Okay. So like when they had the virtual convention this year, we loved what you did, at your house. That was at your house, right? Where you had the big event.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That was awesome. So, I guess now do you have a lot of local people under
yes.
you?
Yes.
Okay.
So we have a large local team. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, but anybody that you guys, I mean, seriously, you guys, she had a great event. So that's one thing that we want to do maybe one of these days too, is like, you know, once we, you know, grow a little bit bigger and stuff, it's like, you know, have some of our team come together like that. We enjoyed watching you and your team, all the things you did when you attended the welcome signs, you did this, you had a great event. So,
yeah.
Yeah. But I think that's all the questions I had. You pretty much covered everything. And like I say, Melody, seriously, congratulations on, you know, reaching Diamond. Oh yeah. I forgot to tell you guys at the beginning too, that Greg and I actually got to meet Melody, her husband and her daughter at Leaders Retreat in San Diego.
Yeah.
If you ever get a chance to meet them in person, you will absolutely fall in love with them. I mean, seriously, they're good people. They're very good people. And we're so excited about the convention in Las Vegas again.
We just
hope that, you know, we'll get to have it. So
I know,
you know, but anyway, okay. Well, Melody, we appreciate you taking the time out to do this for us again. And
you're welcome.
We look forward to seeing you now. When is you're going to be Monday, next Monday? Is that when you're going to be?
Not this coming Monday. It's the Monday after. I think it's the 13th or something. I don't know. The second Monday, I think. Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Yeah. Is what we do. I mean, we usually watch those, but then like our Upline Diamond, Lori, when she mm-hmm. does her Zoom on, she does a Zoom on Tuesday night. A lot of times she'll show that, you know, for people, you know, that's part of her Zoom where she does that. But anyway, like I say, we appreciate it, girl. And
you're welcome.
Keep going. And we're going to cheer you on. Keep, you know, we can't wait to see you reach double diamond. But anyway, well, you take care, girl, okay?
All right, honey.
Okay, love you.
Love you. See ya.
Bye.